Hello, if you're watching this video, then you must be a high leveler. My name is Ray O'Daniel and welcome to my channel. In this video, what we're going to talk about is how to create the ultimate best snapshot to be either used by your client or possibly even resell. Before we get started, if you have not subscribed, please hook a brother up and click on the subscribe button. I always appreciate your support. I am trying to grow this channel. If you have not signed up for Highlevel and you're looking to sign up, please use my affiliate link. You get all of my videos, all of my training, and my support to get your account set up. So right now, in this video, what we're going to end up talking about is how to basically take the best of the best of all the snapshots, all the special things that you've created in your own sub accounts, and how to combine them to make the ultimate best snapshot that you can either deploy to your client, or you can even possibly put it up on the marketplace and resell it to other high levelers. So the training has already been sort of made, so we're going to cut right into it. Thanks so much and have a great day. Basically take multiple snapshots and then create your own snapshot from it. Okay, well, let's walk through that real quick here. So we're going to come back over to switch up an agency view and sub account. Now, right now, I guess for the purposes of this, let's go ahead and create an account. I'm just going to choose a blank. I'm not going to choose any one of these, just a blank snapshot, add account manually. So, business name, test user Inc. Sorry for this guy's here. Like this guy will be, we'll put him in New York. We'll go down to the use and go to United States, New York. I have no idea what a New York zip code is. And we'll choose a time zone of Eastern here. And don't have time for all this. I'll just, maybe not the best time zone here, but I want to handle speed here. So let's say we created a sub account here, and the purpose of this sub account is strictly to create a pristine snapshot for anything else that you want to add in here. So once you've got this, let me kind of say we can deploy as many snapshot objects as we want into this account and just dump everything in here if we want to create a huge massive one. So we're already in the sub account. So we're going to click on action and load snapshot. Now here from the snapshot, let's just say we're going to be dealing with a marketing agency. So I'm going to choose the marketing agency snapshot from Highlevel's perspective. I'm going to click proceed. Now, here's all the things that they give you with it. So I'm going to choose skip, but let's just say I want to choose all the calendars, the campaigns, custom values, all the forms they've got, you know, any surveys, and all the triggers, and maybe the pipelines. So those are all the things that I want to put from the marketing snapshot into this new sub account. So I can click proceed. Now, checking for conflicts, there should be no conflicts. Why? Because the sub account is empty. It has nothing. So we're going to choose overwrite. Just choose overwrite on all of them. Click proceed, confirm. And we can confirm. Boom. So now what we've done is we've taken all of those objects from the marketing vertical snapshot and pushed them into this account. Now we don't have to stop there. Let's just say we want to come over here, actions, and load another snapshot. So we're going to come down here and let's just say that we've got, the affiliate snapshot that I used before, and we want to add some things in here. So we're going to skip everything and we're going to add, just say, all the custom fields from here. We're going to add that membership offer for the client onboarding course. That's going to be a cool thing that we can add in here. And I want to add all of the workflows that we've got here. So all of those objects, notice I'm skipping some of the funnels. Maybe I don't want to add any funnels on this one here, but I only want to take these objects from this snapshot and move them over. And let's just see, no conflicts detected. Perfect. So we can go ahead and click proceed, click confirm. So now we've pushed in all the marketing verticals and then all of the affiliate snapshot objects that we want, but we don't have to stop there. We can come up here to load another snapshot. Let's go down to these, I'm not exactly sure what I put in here, so forgive me, but it looks like these are some websites that I put together. So right now, let's just say I want to skip all of them, but I want to come down to funnels and websites, and I want to select all of them. So here we've got just some funnels, websites. I'm not sure what they're about. Can't remember. But those are the ones that we want to do. Oh, review settings. We might want to put in some review settings that are in here. Some email, missed call, text back, some SMS. So we want to have all of that. Now, here's where it says there's a few conflicts. So now this is where you have to sit back and see which ones you want to test. Obviously, if you take a look here, there's some detection in the missed call text back. So this is where you'd have to go back, what we did before, take a look at it, see if it's something that you overwrite. But if you don't really care, this is a test one anyway. We just proceed to overwrite it because we really want the settings in this snapshot and to overwrite and be the predominant ones in this one versus whatever settings were already there. We just want to overwrite it. So now that we've done all this, what we can do is simply come back into our test user Inc. account. And now what we end up getting here, some of these snapshots may still be loading, but if we wanted to, we could look at calendars. You know, here's, you know, book a call, demo request. Here's all the different calendars that are in here. We can simply look at the automations. You know, here's all the folders for like contact management for all these. The ones from the affiliate ones that I was talking about. Here's some of the Facebook Messenger bots and the Google My Business bot stuff that's in here. So do you kind of see what we did here? We started with a blank account and then used all the best things of all these other snapshots to create a great snapshot that you can now use to create your client accounts. You could use to turn around and sell this if you want. You could do anything that you want with this, but this is how you can take any of the snapshots that you've got, whether it be your ones you created yourself, the ones that you imported, or even the vertical ones that already exist inside of Highlevel. You can use any one of those, deploy them into a sample snapshot account, and then what we can do is then take this and create a snapshot from it. So if we wanted to, we can come back over in here. Once this is all done, go to settings, come over to snapshot, and just click on the create new snapshot button. So once we do that, we would give it a name. Now I'm not gonna execute this. I'm just gonna simply say test user, but now we can come down and select the new test user account. This is the one we created specifically for the snapshot, and we can just click save. And now all of the objects inside of that account that we've imported from all these other different snapshots will then be able to be uploaded, or used as a snapshot in the future. So guys, I hope this really is of value to you for those people out there that really just didn't understand snapshots, how to deploy snapshots. Now, I've shown you how to do a few things here, but snapshots are a great way to deploy anything that you want, any updates or anything like that to clients at all. Now, the one thing that I will tell you about this is that there is no way inside of Highlevel at this time to automate any of this. So the deployment, you notice as you go through the snapshot wizard, there is no way to automate that. Okay, so that you're going to have to do it manually, and it's going to have to be done on a per client basis. So that right there kind of leaves something open. Depends on how many clients you have and how many things you want to deploy, but you can very well train a VA or something like that to go through the same process that we did in this video to deploy, to rename, create duplicate objects, store those objects in an archive folder, whatever they are. You can train somebody to do all that and then deploy these to your clients. So hopefully you found this helpful. If you did, click on the like button, leave me a comment, and just, if things were good or if they weren't, maybe you're unclear about a few things here, leave me a comment. I always answer all of my comments. I just want to say thank you very much for visiting my channel, and a little plug here. If you have not subscribed, please click the subscribe button. And if you are interested in signing up for Highlevel, please use my affiliate link. I do get compensated. Again, I appreciate you in advance. Have a great day.